Hey, what's up, y'all? Welcome back to another video, and for this video, I'm going to be doing a square piece guide on how to play this game. And this game is fun, and it's clean, and very nice graphics. It's a very nice game. And without further ado, let's get into the video.
Winner.
What you doing out of day? Slick talker since a jet.
Winter time, all the time, ooh, yeah. Look at the way that I move, swag. Disrespectful and I'm rude,
okay.
I had cocaine in the school, winter one hell of a kid,
I am.
Smoking gas.
Okay, so now when you spawn in the game, you're gonna spawn in somewhere that's called Mr. Fine's Village. This is the starter island. This is where you want to grind money and grind levels so you can eventually be better at the game. So now, this is the entire island right here. And this is the middle area where you want to start grinding. This is the first NPCs you're going to get a quest on. And so right here, this is where all the NPCs are. This is their first quest you're going to get. And if you come over here, the quest man is right below you at the left. So you want to come down here and you want to get the quest for these NPCs right here. And these NPCs right here are called the bandits, because they're like the noobs of the game, like the noobs NPCs. So when you spawn in, you're only gonna have something called melee in your inventory. So it's like right there, only one thing. And so what you want to do with your melee is you want to get the first quest for these NPCs and this NPC man. And that's all you basically do to grind money at the start. And so you get the quest and you kill the NPCs, like the first one, the five bandits. You get the first one, the 1500 belly. You get it, and then you kill them, and then you come back and keep grinding. And you wanna basically do this quest until you can one-shot all these NPCs. Like, you wanna keep doing it over and over again till your melee stats become better. And so you see, at first, you're gonna be able to only equip one bandit quest. Cause for me, I bought something called quest scrolls. And I'm going to be explaining that later in the video. And so you see, you get the quest and you get the money for it. And so for this beginner quest, you get 2,146 belly for it. And you just want to do this quest until you can basically one-shot them. And after you can one-shot them, it means you're strong enough to move on to the next level. And so the next level is, instead of bandits, it's a slightly harder quest. They do more damage and they have more health, but then it's gonna be able to grind, to be help you grind better. And these are the noobs right here, the NPC called noobs. And when you get their quest, they give you more money, but they're stronger and they have more health. And so I'll show you the quest right now. And you just want to get it. And you can, as I said before, you can only equip one quest because you haven't activated all the quest scrolls you have. So you just do this quest and you kill five moves. And instead of you getting 2,146 belly, you get 4,000. And so there's, you can see a big boost right there. And now you just want to do this until you can one-shot them like the other NPCs. And once you can one-shot them, it means you've gotten stronger. And now the next quest is going to be the monkey quest. And the monkey quest, they're a bit farther apart from each other. And now remember, the main goal at the start of this game is to try to get 500,000 belly. Like, this 500,000 belly is important for you to, for your grinding. It's gonna help you a lot. And so once you're strong enough to go to the next levels, you're gonna come to the monkeys over here, and you need to kill five of them. And they basically give you a bigger amount of money. See, instead of 4,000 like the noobs, you get 6,000. So the first quest gives you 2,000 money overall. The next quest gives you 4,000 overall. And the last quest gives you 6,000 overall. And so the monkeys are just opposite of where the bandits are. And so if you do that, you essentially want to get to 4. Okay, so now when we're done with all the grinding and we have 500k belly. So now this is what I've been talking about since the start of the video. This is why this 500k belly is so important. Now we're gonna be able to buy Blackleg. So this is a fighting style that has the largest AoE in the game, like the largest hitbox. It means it's gonna be so much easier for us to grind now that we have Blackleg. And so, if you don't know where a Blackleg is, you could either watch this video right now, or you can ask a friend to take you to where Sanji is, which I'll show you in a moment. And so, now that we're going to be able to buy Blackleg, it's going to be so much easier for us to grind. Because literally, you can be 20 meters away from an NPC, you can do a move, and it's going to affect them. Like, that's how high the AoE is. And so I know a lot of people, there's a bunch of other fighting styles in the game. There's Fishman Karate and there's Electro. And so Electro's okay, but I prefer Blackleg because it does so much damage and it has a big hitbox. Fishman Karate doesn't have that much range, but it does good damage, but not as good as Blackleg. So as a beginner in this game, you want to farm to 500k belly, and you want to come to here. So right here, it's behind, so where the middle town is, it's right behind it. So you just take a boat and you sail straight and you find here, and Sanji should be behind this place. And so here is Sanji in Barati, the water restaurant. And so when you click on Sanji, he's gonna tell you he just learned a new style called Blackleg. Do you want to buy it for 500k belly? And so when you buy it for 500k belly, you automatically have all the skills already. That's what's very good about it. So the first skill is anti mana kick course. It's the Q move. See how big that hitbox is? It's so beautiful, like it's so nice, and it does a lot of damage. And so the next C, it even has very long range. Like, you can use it to travel. So like, if you have to go to somewhere really far and you don't like want to buy a boat, you can take this to travel with it. It gives you a very long range. And so after it, the next skill is gonna be Mouton Shot, the E move. And this skill, it makes you go high into the sky and then it drops you back down, dealing a lot of damage. So I'll show you right now. So let me press the E move and I go up and I come back down. And it does so much damage and has a big hitbox. Now the last skill is called Table Party Kick. So once you, when you do this, this has the highest AoE in the game. It's so big, it literally hits everywhere. Look at it. It's so beautiful too. And now, what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna showcase this on NPCs to show you how good it is. So let me reset. Alright, now I'm gonna go over to the noobs NPCs and I'll show you how good this fighting style is, Blackleg. And so let me come over here to the noob quest. Let me equip Flambe Jambe. So the F skill increases your damage and like long-term damage as well. So see, that's the Q move. That's how big it is. It just literally demolishes everywhere. That's the Q move. And now that's another Q move again. See, all the NPCs in that area got cleared. Now this is the E move. See that? That's just so nice. And so that's why you need Blackleg as a beginner. That's why you need Blackleg so badly as a beginner. And now I'm gonna show you the table party kick. See how big that is? See it? All the NPCs in that circle gets damaged. That's how very nice it is. And so now we bought our black leg. So what's gonna be the next thing to do? Since we can one-shot all these NPCs over here. Now, the next place you want to go is, first, you want to get something called an island tracker from this NPC right here. It costs 50k belly. Or you can tell a friend to buy it for you and give it to you. And I'm willing to give to any of the fans out there if you need one. You can comment down below and ask me if you need one. I will gladly send one to you in my game. And so where we want to go now, we want to go to Shellstown. So the way to use this island tracker is to go in first person mode, and you see that arrow? You look for where you're going. So we're going to Shellstown now. And so you just equip the boat, or you tell your friend to buy you one. Or you can use your blackleg skills to get there. But I'd just rather buy a boat. And so now where we want to go is Shellstown. So there's a surprise at Shellstown. Most beginners don't know. So at first you might think this game is so boring, like what is this game? But when you start getting, you know, deep into the game, it becomes more fun. Like there's so many interesting things to do in the game. So now we're gonna try to go to Shellstown. I always mess up because I always misclick where we're going. And so now let's just sail to Shellstown then. And so, Shellstown, there's a mystery there. Like, most of the people that just started the game don't know anywhere around the map. But, like, if you have a friend that's willing to help you with it, it's going to be way easier. So, there's an NPC at Shellstown that sells you something very, very interesting. So, see, right here now, I messed up. Because now, on the island tracker, I'm tracking Zolzaland. It's supposed to be Shellstown, and now I mess up again. I click on Logtown instead of Shellstown. And so we're just going around in circles until we find where we're going. So now, this gives me the time to explain to you the NPC at Shellstown. So that NPC is someone called Zoro. I know we all know Zoro, the master of the sword, right? And so, if we go to Zoro, he sells one sword style, two sword style, and three sword style. And so, one sword style costs the same amount as blackleg. It costs 500k belly. And when you get that, you get four moves you can use with the sword. So, it's the first one is your slash, which is your click, your M1. The next one is like a one sword, it's called niggery. Like, I'm sorry to all the people black out there, maybe I pronounced it wrongly, but with your one sword style, your two sword style, and your three sword style, you get four moves in total. And those four moves, like, that's very nice. It helps you grind, because like if your moves for blackleg like are all out, you can just pull out your sword and you can, you know, you can train with it. And so, like, this game, I just started this one day, right? And I just kept grinding. Like, it took me about 6 hours. I got three sword style. I got black leg. I got hockey. And I got chop fruit. So, I mean, if we all think about it, if you just put a little bit of time to this game, you're going to have it maxed out. Because if you're like one of your other like you liked games get shut down or for an update or something, you can just hop on to Square Piece and you can just play this, you know, for the time being. And now, where we're heading to, we're gonna head back over to Shellstown. And over there, that's the next place you need to grind. You just grind NPCs there, and you meet Zoro. And so when you're grinding NPCs there, you're going to be gradually having money to buy the sword. So one sword style is something called Suzaku. That's the one sword style. And then two sword style is Suzaku and Kitetsu. And then that's for 750,000 belly. And so the next style is for 5 million belly. It's Suzaku and Kitetsu and Mugijun. So the three of them is what makes up the sword style. And when you get that, you get a range of moves. There are always four moves. So the first move is click, which is your slash, your M1. And the next one is Hydra. You bring out like 7 dragons from your sword, and they all land on one opponent. The next one is Sansen Sekai, the 3,000 worlds, and you bring out the 3 swords, and you make a green spinning effect around you, and it does a lot of OP damage. And for the last move, it's just, your clicks, man. And this sword style is very good for grinding. So now that we're in Shelltown, this is the NPC man that's gonna give us the quest. And now if we come over here, let's go over there. Up there are gonna be the Marines, which is your quest NPCs. And so now this is where we finally meet the legendary Zoro. Right here. This is where you're gonna get your 1 sword style, 2 sword style, and 3 sword style. And now these are the NPCs you're gonna be working on to achieve your goal. All of them, so these are Marine NPCs. They all give 10,000 belly for each quest. But then with your quest scrolls, which you need to activate, you can beg a friend for it, or you can grind money for it. So it's the first quest scroll you get is to activate 1 extra quest for you. It's for 500k. The next is 1 mil, then 1.5 mil, and then 2 mil, then 2.5 mil to activate all of them. And so if you activate all of them, you'll be getting around 50,000 belly every time you do this quest, which is really going to help you. And so this is going to be the end of the starter guide for episode 1. And that's it. That's all you need to know. And so on the next episode, I'll be showing you a lot more of quests and new training location. All right, peace.